opened its doors in early winter of 1975. Destined to become one of the grandest amusement parks in the United States, Karen Corporation set out to push the boundaries of what it meant to provide immersive entertainment. To this day, it's unclear how exactly Liminal Land garnered such a passionate and sizable audience so quickly, as the town of Lake Valley has historically had a relatively small population. Regardless, ticket sales exploded from day one, much to the credit of large families who flew in from all over the world to experience CHARON's experimental vision. From the beginning, Liminal Land was always embedded with one mission: to dethrone Disneyland as the go-to destination for thrill-seekers of all ages. Coasters that evoked emotion, a multi-tiered water park, and a massive underground suburbia were among the experiences being tested while the park was open, and to this day, debates are plentiful on whether Karen actually achieved their goal of industry dominance. It's rumored that Disneyland was relatively empty throughout the 1980s, however, Disney loyalists will consistently deny that. No matter which way you look at it though, the impact of Liminal Land's existence was always clear, and, at least for a brief while, it appeared that the park wasn't ever going anywhere. Very little news coverage came out of Lake Valley during Liminal Land's tenure. Park goers seemed avid to serve as test subjects for their experimental rides, and it felt like no one ever batted an eye. Regardless of the numerous accidents that took place over the years, there was never a single investigation, audit, or inspection ever credibly done. What Liminal Land touted as anomalous events were simply tarped off for a day and reopened thereafter with not a single word about them. For 14 years, the park operated in this bizarre manner. People went missing, rides consistently changed, and the park's staff were always apathetic about it. Yet Liminal Land's popularity paradoxically appeared to grow. Entrance hub to Subliminal Land, its experimental water park located underneath Liminal Land. Unfortunately, on May 20th of 1989, Liminal Land's day of reckoning had come. That night, the park was rapidly and indefinitely shut down, with no concrete reason ever being given. The remains of those present on that fateful night are rumored to remain exactly where they were last seen, although nobody really knows for sure. Theme park preservationists are keen to keep the spirit of Liminal Land alive, however. There has been nothing like it for decades, and probably never will. The Hall of Walls. Paradise Playrooms. Subliminal Land. The Laugh Track. Centrifuge. Skyliner. Unknown. The Chrysanthemum. Unknown. Serpentine. Funhouse. Welcome Home. One of the finer creations of Liminal Land Park came with the creation of their flagship accommodation, the Holistic and Opportune Mutual Experience, or HOME. The HOME project encompassed a sprawling underground suburbia, perfect for families who traveled from out of state to experience Liminal Land for themselves. Built from the repurposed bones of the Lake Valley Observatory employee housing structure, the site once housed the facility's clean energy workers and their families, at the time creating one of the largest underground communities in existence. Upon its opening, Liminal Land aimed to celebrate this sense of community by transitioning Home's purpose away from employees and geared towards park visitors, many of whom felt overwhelmingly comfortable while inside due to its illusory nature. This sensation of homeliness was the sole intention behind the project, as Karen sought to keep guests inside the park for as long as possible in hopes of maximizing profits. Because of this goal, Home would be the only in-park hotel offered to guests, reportedly containing around 10,000 concurrent operational rooms at its peak, spread out over a handful of square miles underneath Liminal Land. Rough approximation of Home's size relative to Liminal Land. Some areas are rumored to be unexplored to this day. Blending 50s-inspired decor with modern cues from the 1980s, Home was a marvel for its time. And due to the intrigue and raving reviews surrounding it, Karen would begin selling units in 1981, fulfilling their goal of keeping their patrons on park grounds for as long as humanly possible. Due to the allure of Home and its outward appearance of a sprawling underground suburbia, quick family vacations often turned into extended and even permanent stays. And for many, Liminal Land Park had indefinitely become home. Look at the photo. 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 Thank you.
7 years of my life, living out my wildest dreams. Rocky, my dad.
Cause I'm ready, ready, ready.
This is built on their shoulders.
Ready or not.
One step, one punch, one round at a time.
Well, you all now, Lil Donnie.
I'm on it all, cause I'm ready, ready or not.
Last time I seen that look, it was on Apollo.